Do you want to analyze your data in SmartSuite, but you don't have the time to manually build all of the analytic tools that you would need? Well, look no further, friend, because in this video, I am showcasing one of the most powerful ways that SmartSuite integrates with artificial intelligence. We are going to be breaking down how you can analyze your data, the existing data inside of your SmartSuite solution, instantly with AI. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting. We make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. One of our favorite no-code tools is SmartSuite. And if you aren't already using SmartSuite in your workflows, you will find that it can help you save up to 20 hours of your time every week per person on your team, frankly, thanks to no-code automation and just ultimately better organization for your company, for your team. So, if you are new to SmartSuite, go ahead and grab a free trial using our link below. This will show some love back to the channel, but also make you available for some exclusive SmartSuite swag if and when you upgrade in the future. Of course, if you are an existing SmartSuite customer, go ahead and pop open your SmartSuite account and follow along as best you can. I do want to preface by saying that some of these features might not yet be released. They are being slowly rolled out in alpha and beta testing. So if you don't have access for your account, you might have to give it a week or two, or you might request that access from the SmartSuite team when you are ready to do so. So let's go ahead and pop on in and see the system that we've set up. Now, I do want to point out that actually this entire solution that I'm sharing with you here was generated using AI. This was AI that we utilized in a previous video on this playlist that showcased how you can build a solution from scratch in SmartSuite just by communicating to AI. Now, this is not the example output from that specific video, but I did go back into that AI generator and say, hey, I wanna see a way where I can track my revenue against my clients inside of a SmartSuite solution. And it gave me this, including all of the sample data that you see here. So if you missed those previous videos on that playlist, be sure to go back and check out the other ways that SmartSuite is really leaning into AI, because they are at the forefront of no code and AI integration. So go ahead and check that out. But now we're gonna do a quick little recap of what we have right here, and then we're gonna proceed with getting some stuff built for us using the AI generator. So here inside of our revenue application, we're looking at revenue. So we have an item that we've purchased here, or that was purchased from us, I should say. And next to that, we're gonna see our total amount. So what was the amount on that? When did we receive this money? When was it paid? And who is the client? Now, this of course is a linked relationship. If we flip into clients, we can see over here that we have an email address. We have the name of the client, name of the person rather, as well as the name of the company. And then of course it's linked to revenue. And on our total revenue here, we've got a nice little formula that's looking at the revenue and summing the total amount of revenue. So that in the example here where we've got ABC Enterprises, they've purchased a sponsored video and a course from us. The course, if we drill in, we can see that this was a $780 transaction, roughly. And the sponsored video here was a roughly $900 transaction. So that sum is being generated from that information a layer deeper in our solution. So in our case, that's in our revenue application. So that's how this particular thing is currently working. Now let's get to the AI generator. So maybe I want to analyze my revenue data. Let's go ahead and flip back into revenue. And over here in my revenue, I am looking at, again, my different total amounts and, you know, who made those purchases and of course when they were made. Actually, just to make this a little bit easier, let's go ahead and throw out a sort on the date paid field so that we can see things in chronological order. I'm happy with that. And there we go. January, March, and May. So that's great. Everything is now in order. Of course, we could flip that around if we wanted to see it the other way. But maybe I want to see this data represented graphically on a chart. Well, I don't always necessarily want to go out and manually build all the different charts. I could, of course, create a view, add a dashboard, add charts to the dashboard, or I could just create a chart right off the bat and say, hey, I just need to see this specific data, throw it into a chart and group it, organize it a certain way. Well, in my example here, maybe I don't want to go through that manual process. Thanks to AI, I no longer have to. So in the bottom right-hand corner of my screen, next to the intercom option here, which, side note, this is a great way to get support from the SmartSuite team. If you haven't used it already, their support is top-notch. But right next to that, we see the little magic dust right here, the little stars, which is becoming the universal symbol for artificial intelligence. If I click on here, I get this little AI assistant popping up that says, hey, ask me anything. So I will. I'm gonna say, hi, I'd like to see my revenue data graphed over time. Please produce this graph for me. And let's give it a shot. Now, while we're waiting for the AI to think, I'll just go through my normal spiel whenever interacting with AI. Generally speaking, if it doesn't give you the result you want, I want to have the perspective that the default thought here should be that we didn't give it the right information. So generally speaking, the more information you give an AI prompt, the better output you're going to receive from that prompt. As you can see though, as I was jabbering on there, this has already produced a report for us. And so we've got this little report here that we can click on. But what I've experienced in testing this is when I click on it, as I just tried to do, nothing really happens here. So what I have found in order to fix this is to refresh the page. If I go in the upper right or upper left corner and I hit the refresh or just hit F5, now I get this. So let's see what exactly that did. If I go over to my views, you will see that I originally was working from my grid view. And once I refreshed the page, it automatically reloaded with the revenue over time view. So this might just be a bug. In fact, that's my guess, that while they're working out the alpha and beta testing of this particular AI interface connection here, that it is just not properly loading that thing. But you do see that it produced the right view for me. And I'm sure that within no time at all, this bug will be fixed. And when we click on view the report, it just properly loads from the first place. So here I am able to see a line chart, it looks like. So it's automatically created this for me, a line chart. It's given my total amount and it's grouping by date paid. And so on my horizontal axis here, I am seeing the dates as they progress. On my vertical axis, I'm seeing the amount of money that was received. So this is pretty good, but maybe I don't like this. Maybe I want to change some parts of this. Like I don't want to see a line graph. So maybe I need to get more specific in the way that I'm interacting with that artificial intelligence. So let's pop it open again and say, please show me my revenue data on a bar graph. Let's say on a vertical bar graph that graphs date paid over the horizontal axis and revenue received on the vertical axis. Please bucket my horizontal axis by the month. So rather than seeing date all next to each other, I want to see all of January data inside of January, February, March, April, etc. So let's see if it's able to give me a good output here. I'm going to go ahead and hit enter, sit back and relax. That's the beauty of AI, is that, you know, you have to do a little bit of work giving it the information that you want, putting the information in the prompt, and then you get to kind of sit back and relax. And that, what, it took all of 6-7 seconds as I was just continuing to chat. All right, let's click it. Again, not loading properly. It actually took us back to the original view and the grid view here. But again, I'm gonna go ahead and refresh my page, hit F5 or go up to your browser and refresh. And I think it's gonna take us to the right place. It did. This is pretty good, although you'll notice it's not 100% what I was looking for. I do have my revenue totals. I do have things grouped by date, but I'm not seeing the bucketed data that I had asked for. So this might just be a limitation of the AI, or maybe it's just not able to understand you know, how I wanted to see that. And I'm also noticing that it's flipping this information. It's I wanted to see the dates across the horizontal and the totals against the vertical axis. And of course it gave us those things reversed. So here I'm looking at a horizontal bar graph as opposed to a vertical bar graph that I was expecting to see. Now, that being said, it's not 100% perfect, but it still got us pretty darn close to what we're looking for. So is AI perfect? Again, I think we should revisit our expectations and make sure that we as users are first making sure that we are putting in the best information possible so that we can get the output that we expect. And in the case where AI doesn't give us what we were expecting to see, then we should first look and say, well, the fault is probably on me. I could have been more specific and I could have probably asked for this in a better way. So I will have to take the brunt of this, but I also assume that because this is in early alpha and or beta testing right now, that it might still just need a little bit of ironing out. So I don't know about this specific one, and I also don't know what we can do to get better results in terms of integrating our SmartSuite account, maybe with a paid integration to OpenAI or a similar tool, but I'm sure these things are also coming as we continue to push the envelope with AI and no code. Anyhow, I hope you got a ton of value from this video. It's really cool stuff. Give it a shot yourself. See how much time it can start saving you as you want to look at your data, analyze your data so that you have the information that you expect at your fingertips without having to spend hours and hours and hours putting your reports together. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to this channel and like the video if you got value from it. And of course, in the meantime, keep on building.